Alright, welcome LEGO fans to a video that I think is long overdue. I've been meaning to do it for a while, and I just kind of rearranged things, so I thought it'd be a great time to do it. And of course, as you can see in the title of the video, this is a long-expected brick tour. So I'll be showing you where I keep all my LEGO models, spare parts, the bin of doom, instruction booklets, sets I'm about to review, and maybe you'll learn a few things along the way. Some lighting tips, some shelving tips, cool stuff like that. So I hope you learned something, I hope you enjoy it as well, and let's go ahead and get started. So most of the stuff is in my room, but then there's also another room where I keep a few things, and you'll get some my spare parts bin, the bin of doom, and I believe every set that we've reviewed so far. So let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so here's the famous work and film table. So that's where all the sets are built, where I do 95% of the reviews that are on here. So it's a very, very special place. And it's also where I keep some of the, well, I should say it's where I keep some of the sets that I'm going to be reviewing soon. So as you can see, there's a new robot on the way, Strider. Pretty cool stuff right here. I think you're going to love him. And then also the container truck, which I do need to do some maintenance on before I can review. I don't know exactly when I'll get around to that, but hopefully it'll be on here before too long. Also have my Hobbit calendar, scissors for opening up the Lego boxes. I can open the bags by hand. Brick separator, always gonna have at least one of these on your table. And I'll just write down the specifics for the LEGO sets if I don't have the information on the box. Which is if I don't have the box. And a little flashlight in case some LEGO pieces fall under a cabinet or such thing. We'll go ahead and start here, I guess. Got lots of Star Wars stuff over here. Here's the Republic frigate. Probably either my most or second most impressive LEGO Star Wars set. Which puts it in at least the top 5 most impressive sets, period. Here's my Jabba display. Have all 4 of the new Jabba themed sets here, very proud of it. Got Jabba's Palace up top and on the side here. Rancor Pit underneath. Awesome stuff right there. And over here we've got the Sarlacc pit escape scene, the Great Pit of Carcoon, with the Desert Skiff, Han Solo borrowed from Jabba's palace, the Sarlacc pit itself, and of course Jabba's sail barge in the background there, all kinds of opening doors and stuff, Boba Fett from the Desert Skiff. Underneath that, I've got the items that I use for my Relics of the Past and Present videos. Got some alligator heads, dinosaur skulls, claws, teeth, ammonites, trilobites, all kinds of cool stuff. Beneath that is my work in progress, kind of, the Battle of Naboo display. There's not a whole lot here, but I wanted to be able to put my MTT in a prominent location since it's new, so I went ahead and put the Battle of Naboo set there with it as well. Underneath that is my Episode 4 Tatooine display with Mos Eisley Cantina, Droid Escape, and why did you say it on here? Someone must have taken those off. Bit fan, where did it? Whoops. And the Imperial dropship, which isn't actually in the movie. It's not in any of the movies, but it goes along with it nicely, I think. And some more stormtroopers. Below that, it's just kind of 2 miscellaneous sets. The Home 1 Mon Calamari Star Cruiser. And the Gungan Sub with Queen Amidala and my Kolo Clawfish mock. Under here, we've got some spare parts that I got from the LEGO store. And let's go ahead and check this out over here. This is kind of a mash of stuff. Got some Hobbit stuff, Star Wars City. And above that is my Master of Lake Town portrait. It's my self-portrait. It's very expensive to get done, but I'm glad I got it done because I think it captures my likeness very well. Very well indeed. And John Still. Here's Dol Guldur. Still a work in progress now that Witch King Battle is going to be coming out pretty soon. But that's the bulk of it, of course. Got Azog the Defiler. Beorn. Lots of work. Radagast the Brown up there. Next to that, we've got another work in progress still. Lake Town. Lake Town Chase, to be exact. Still waiting on Lake Town. Attack on Lake Town, something like that. Coming out October or December, either one. Probably December, since it's not like about time yet. Also, we got the end of Unexpected Journey down here with Goblin King Battle. With His Majesty the Goblin King. Riddles of the Ring over here. And Attack of the Wargs. Beneath that, we've got two miscellaneous sets. We've got the mobile police unit with a motorcycle and burglar car. And Duelon Geonosis, my one and only episode 2 set, so it's kind of off by itself. And below that, I've got my Battle of Endor mock. I borrowed the AT-ST for my Battle of Hoth display, though. Look, this is one of my favorites. It's okay. That's why it's on the bottom. And here's a box where I keep some more of the stuff that I'm going to be reviewing soon. Got the Ocean Interceptor all set. And the Technic set as well. Battle of Naboo. Instruction booklet. There's my old camera. Then, over here, is probably the best display area. Because it's all the rest of my Lord of the Rings and Hobbit sets. So on the bottom here, we've got the most impressive sets. They're at eye level, so that's why they're here. Got Pirate Ship Ambush. Very cool set. Sails really set it off. Then we got the Battle of Helm's Deep with Uruk-hai Army, of course. King Theoden riding out into the fray. And Éomer, of course. Now you're probably thinking, why is the Orc Forge down here with your rest of your most impressive sets? Well, it goes nicely with Orthonk. And of course Orthonk is the most impressive set. It's probably my number one favorite set of all time that I own. So that's why that's there and Orc Forge goes with it. Orc Forge is probably my least favorite Lord of the Rings set though. Probably. Definitely top two least favorite. Above that, we've got medium stuff. It's pretty good. Not quite as impressive as this, though. Got Wizard Battle. Yes, it made it to the middle shelf because it's so cool. Attack on Weathertop. I know a lot of people didn't like that one, but I liked it. Gandalf Arrives to End. I'm going to expect the Gathering. Put it right in the middle because it's the best one that's on this shelf. It's nice and colorful too. I might say it's the best Hobbit set yet. That's gonna change when The Lonely Mountain comes out, almost certainly. But for now, I think it's the best Hobbit set. Council of Elrond, along with Unexpected Gathering, a nice change in the grays and browns from most of the sets. Got some orange and white. And Shelob Attacks barely made it here, but it did. It's pretty good. And we get good old Samwise Gamgee in it as well. And Gollum. And then above that, it's probably they're still great, most of them, but not quite as good. We've got Escape from Mirkwood Spiders. I tucked that back in the farthest corner because of that. We didn't want that, I didn't want it in a prominent location. And I decided to put the rest, and this is a pretty awful set too. It's okay, because of Thranduil and the Brown Warg, and of course I want to complete my Hobbit collection. But
it's probably the worst Hobbit set yet. Maybe even worse than Riddles of the Ring. Maybe. Probably not. But it's still pretty bad. For your money, it's worse. For the amount you're spending. And Barrel Escape, I was reluctant to put it up here with them because it is a really good set. But I wanted to keep all the Mirkwood stuff together, so that's why it is up there. And it has been out for quite a while in a prominent location. Mines of Moria, I was reluctant to put up here as well. But going between that and Dol Guldur, Dol Guldur had been in that far corner for a very long time, so I thought it was a chance to let it get the spotlight. And maybe a little more fun. I like the Mines of Moria scene better, but the set might be better. And that is where Black Gate should be, but I'm using that for my... I'm going to be doing a conversations video of that soon, so I went ahead and took it down. So we'll go ahead and get to the rest of the shelves over here very, very soon. In fact, in just a few nanoseconds. Alright, shelves round two. Here is where I keep a lot more Star Wars stuff and then a few other miscellaneous things. So, we got Motorcycle Chase. One of the coolest Indiana Jones sets. And next to it, Race for the Stolen Treasure. Got the X-Wing Starfighter and the TIE Fighter. Darth Vader's TIE Advanced right next to each other. Hard to see, but I don't know. I thought some of the other Star Wars sets were just a little cooler. Not quite as iconic, but I personally think they're just a bit cooler. Especially the Cantina and the Jabba stuff. Republic Frigate. And I switch things around every once in a while too. Give them all their fair chance to show off a bit. General Grievous Wheel Bike, and then a bunch of little sets, the Death Star Troopers, Utapau Troopers, Clone Troopers versus Droidicas, Battle on Sabukami, the Rebel Trooper. Oh, I always forget that what that thing is called, but it was my first set. Clone Arc 170 Starfighter back there, very similar to the X-Wing. Also got Dino Defense Headquarters up here. So you can see the T-Rex, hopefully. Yes, it's a little dark up here. Should probably get some lights. And yes, I'm ashamed to say there is a Mega Bloks thing up here. I've never reviewed it. If you'd like to see me review it, please tell me in the comments. But I know that people are very strict about Lego purism. So I just haven't reviewed it. I haven't taken it down, though. I'm just kind of lazy. I thought about taking it down seriously, and I'm thinking I'm probably going to pretty soon. But if you would like to see a review of it, let me know and I will do it. But I thought, for now at least, I'm going to keep it Lego purist. Unless you guys don't want it like that, please let me know if you don't. So that is the second shelf area. A few other things in here. We've got some minifigures and the exclusive Minecon Lego Steve, which means something to me now that I like Minecraft. A couple of minifigures there. We've also got one of my mocks, the Grand mock I've kept around for some reason. Don't know why. And just a little Clone Wars display with a Geonosian cannon. Little walker. And another cannon from the Eli Clone Trooper and Commando Droid Battle Pack. And then over here, we have a couple poly bags. The Mars Mission Robot. I had to borrow the astronaut for a project I'm working on. And the hot dog stand and the Piece of Resistance. So it's kind of my little poly bag area. And some non-Lego Dwarves of Erebor. And now here is what I think is probably my best display. And you've probably seen it in a couple of my videos. If you've seen the Snowspeeder review or the AT-AT review, you kind of saw it too. And it's my Battle of Hoth display. Definitely one of my favorites. We got the AT-AT in there, the new Snowspeeder, the Hoth Wampa Cave, an AT, I believe, AT-ST from Battle of Endor that I took, little Snowtrooper Battle Pack, two Echo Bases, one of them actually Echo Base, and one of them kind of like the outer defense of it.
And then the other snow speeder is also from the Hoff Wampa case. So you got like 6 or 7 sets here. And it's definitely one of my favorite displays. If they ever come out with more Hoth sets, I will certainly add to it. And that is about it for here, but I still got another area to show you, amazingly. One more thing though, and it's just the robot. Just keep him in here to work on and show some programs of. Oh yeah, and that's my conversations with myself table. And a couple more things I forgot. There's a lot to show. For a T-Fall that's been collecting for years now, you've got a lot to show, especially if you keep your sets intact. This is my instruction manual bin. This thing is pretty deep, and it's stuffed full of instruction manuals. Not organized or anything. I do recommend you do that, though, because things get a little hairy when you want to find an instruction manual and you can't. And this is my spare parts bin. This bin is from when I was in kindergarten or something. And in it is where all of my spare parts are kept. And it's quite a collection after 100 Lego sets or so. And look at all the brick separators. Let's count. There's one over there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, kind of 13, if you count that. 14, 15, 16, 17, and I've given a couple away. So roundabouts in the 20 area. So, if you guys want a brick separator, just give me your address and I'll send it to you. I got too many of these. And I'll continue to get more since they're including them in every set now, it seems. And then one more thing to show you before my final display area. And that is... old camera, by the way. Oh, two more things. One of them is the green base plate. And the other is... dun dun dun! The Bin of Doom. And this is where... every Lego set of mine that has fallen apart is kept. And the thing is, I brought back a lot of sets this summer, and it still looks like this. And that's the main Bin of Doom. I've also got a smaller one, which I still haven't shown you. I see things just keep popping into my head. I don't think I'm forgetting anything after this, though. Promise I will not let you guys down. If I miss something, I will add it in before I upload the video. So yeah, that is my Bin of Doom. You can see how thick it is there. Pretty darn thick. Just chock full of Lego parts. More Mega Block stuff. Machines have. But that's why it's in the Bin of Doom. So that is the Bin of Doom. And then one more thing I still forgot to show you. Over here. It's kind of like my secondary Bin of Doom. Some more sets in there. A lot of the pieces are still together, at least, so a lot of them did come from here. This thing was way more full than it was, or than it is now, at the beginning of summer. Yeah, you can still see I have a lot of cool stuff, but it's just a pain bringing it back. Big pain, especially when school's going. Summer was a bit different, and I'm quite pleased with the amount that I did bring back. So, one more area. And then, I believe my brick tour will be over. Wait. Yep, you knew it. I have a Lego alarm clock. And Lego books. And then here is where I keep a lot of my non-licensed theme sets. And also a couple other things. Mostly just these, the robotics kits. And the Lego Mindstorms NXT 2.0 Discovery book that I've been using a lot. And the Ultimate Player's Guide to Minecraft. So up here we've got a lot of Atlantis. Actually, this whole shelf is devoted to Atlantis except for that random T-Rex skeleton. And that's Aqua Raiders. Haven't reviewed it. The shark is pretty much intact, but the submarine is not. Would have liked to have brought that back, but maybe some other time. Gateway of the Squid. Atlantis Exploration HQ. A little submarine from another set that for the most part has fallen apart. The Guardian of the Deep. Seabed Scavenger. And last but not least, the Typhoon Turbo Sub. Then the set aside a lot of Lego Dino stuff, some City, some Pharaoh's Quest, a little bit of everything. So I do usually keep one of my Technic sets there, of course. I showed you that. I've taken it down to review. Another one that our two guest stars want to be in. So let's pop it up there for now. And then, yeah, a lot of LEGO Dino stuff, except for the Dino Defense Headquarters. Random glider hanging in the air. Then, yeah, LEGO City. Got the dump truck and the Coast Guard display, which, even though it's only two sets, takes up a lot of space because the one is so awesome. Got the Combine Harvester, White House architecture build, lots of FerroQuest stuff, except for the stuff that, of course, you saw on my table, and the one that's falling apart. LEGO Agents, Lighthouse Creator, the awesome Crawler Crane, which got on here late this summer, Ninjago Spinjitzu Dojo, Dragon Bolt, and another spot for one of my Technic sets. So I think that is it for my brick tour. So thanks for tuning in. Thumbs up if you liked the video. I hope you did. Maybe at some later time when I've got some more stuff, I'll do an updated version. So thanks for staying tuned. This is probably one of my biggest videos in a while. Glad you tuned in. Stay tuned for more, especially especially once we get through September. As Mithrandir said, I believe in her MTT review, September is kind of like the Monday of the year. I'll try and make it as Monday-less as possible if I can, but especially once October, November, and December get here, you're going to see all kinds of uploads with LEGO Hobbit and then just regular Hobbit stuff. So stay tuned for all that. We will see you soon. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing, liking, commenting, telling your friends, and all that good stuff. And I need something really random for this video. I just can't think of anything. Gandalf telling you not to pass unless you study and work hard. Don't ask me.